Assalamualaikum, I am Nadia Koso from Faculty of Education, University of Sindh. Today my presentation topic is Theories of Motivation, assigned by Dr. Amjad Ali Arain. Contents of my presentation are what is motivation, process of motivation, and theories of motivation. What is motivation? Berslin and Stanner define motivation as all those inner striving conditions described as wishes, desires, drives, etc. It is an inner state that activates or moves. Motivation involves effort, persistence, and goals. According to Middlemist and Hitt, motivation refers to a willful desire to direct one's behavior toward goal. This is the process of motivation. Need or deprivation starts or arrives, then drive, tension or drives to fulfill a need is started. And then to fulfill these, actions is taken. Action is a goal-directed behavior. In this process, the satisfaction is achieved. Satisfaction means reduction of the drive of the original need. Now, there are the theories of motivation. These theories are divided into two groups, content theories and process theories. Classification of motivation theories based on the content motivation theories means need motivation, and process motivation theories choose behavior to fulfill their needs. And third one is the reinforcement theory. These are the specific motivation theories under these classification. First theory is Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Maslow's need theory was proposed by Abraham Maslow. Maslow has divided 5 levels of need: higher order needs satisfied internally and lower order needs satisfied externally. Needs are arranged in order of importance. Lower level needs must be met first. Only unmet needs motivate. This is the hierarchy of needs presented by Maslow. The lower level are biological and physiological needs, and safety needs, and then comes belonging needs and love needs, esteem needs, and self-actualization. Whenever the lower level needs are satisfied, the person moves to the higher order level of needs. The second theory is ERG theory, presented by American psychologist Clayton Paul Adelfer. He believed that each need carries some value and hence can be classified as lower order needs and higher order needs. So the core needs, which this theory is composed of, is existence, provision of basic material requirements, relatedness, means desire for relationships, and growth, desire for personal development. Basically, this Adelfer's ERG theory is comprised of condensed form of Maslow's needs. This is the ERG theory. The existing needs are physiological and safety needs. Related needs are social needs and esteem needs, and growth needs are self-actualization needs. Third theory is Hertzberg's two-factor theory, proposed by Frederick Hertzberg. This is also known as motivation hygiene theory. Motivation factors or extrinsic factors are related to lower level needs, and motivating factors or intrinsic factors related to higher level needs. Improving the motivator factors increases the job satisfaction, and improving the hygiene factor decreases the job satisfaction. Third theory is David McLean's theory of needs, or acquired needs theory. In this, the David McLean's divided the needs into three categories. First is need for power, need for affiliation, and need for achievement. Whenever a person has all three are present in each person, but one motivator will dominate. People will have different characteristics depending on their dominant motivator. The fourth theory is equity theory, put forward by John Stacy Adams. According to this theory, an employee who perceives inequity in his or her rewards seeks to restore equity. The theory emphasizes equity in pay structure of employees' remuneration. The dimensions of equity are internal equity, external equity, and individual equity. This is the diagrammatic representation of equity theory process. The fifth theory is expectancy theory, proposed by Victor Room, also known as VIE theory. The strength of a tendency to act in a certain way depends on the strength of an expectation that the act will be followed by a given outcome, and on the attractiveness of that outcome to the individual. This is the diagrammatic representation. Whenever an individual puts effort, he gives the performance, and then on the basis of that performance, he is motivated towards reward. Seventh theory is goal setting theory of motivation. In 1960s, Edwin Locke put forwarded the goal setting theory of motivation. It states that specific and challenging goals along with appropriate feedback contribute to higher and better task performance. In simple words, goals indicate and give direction to an employee about what needs to be done and how much efforts are required to put in. This is the diagrammatic representation of goals theory. Whenever learners behave towards a goal, he gives a performance or set the performance goal or the mastery goals. Last theory is reinforcement theory, the assumption that behavior is a function of its consequences. This is the Skinner's operating conditioning. A behavior, whenever a behavior is performed, if we want to change the behavior or desired positive or undesired negative, we give the punishment. Thank you for watching.